Now I want everybody to go ahead and flip to number two. We're gonna go ahead and I'm gonna teach you, I'm gonna go ahead and demonstrate one of the problems for you because I see some people are having misunderstandings. So everybody go ahead and turn to number two. Let's go, Jamia. Did y'all hear it from me?
Melody went to H-E-B to purchase a bottle of apples for her mother to make her favorite dessert. The scale displayed that she purchased 112
ounces.
The sign says apples are $1.47 per pound. How many pounds of apples did Melody purchase?
Okay, so the first thing we do before we even start to solve our problem, we have to annotate our story. So we have Melody going to purchase some apples for her mom. She purchased 112 ounces. Go ahead and underline 112 ounces. Okay? The sign says that the apples are $1.47 per pound. Go ahead and underline that as well. That might be important. Then we get to our actual question. The question asks, how many pounds of apples did she purchase? I want you to bubble that. When we bubble our question, we have to make sure when we find our answer, that it answers our question, okay? So are we looking for the money-wise part right now? Are we looking for any money?
No.
So what can we do with this $1.47 per pound?
Right.
What can we do, say it right now?
Not proportional.
Not proportional, but what can we do with this? If we're not using it, what can we do with it? When we don't use something, what do we do with it?
X it out.
X it out, we don't need to know it. That's just extra information because our question is asking about pounds. Now, we go to our box that says, what do you know? In this problem, what do we know? By raising our hand, who can tell me what's one thing you know? Karis. Good. She purchased 112 ounces. We know that. That's what the story tells us. We know in the story, they're going to tell us information. Okay? What are we looking for? By raising our hand, what are we looking for again? Somebody other than Karis, because she's hot right now. Elise. Good. We're looking for how many pounds? Who can tell me? By looking at this, the information that we have, the information that we're looking for, who can tell me what do they notice different? Jackie, I saw your hand going. By looking at our two informational things here, what are we looking at? What's happening here? What do we have to do in order to solve this problem? We have to do a proportion because what? Who can help out and let them know why are we doing a proportion? What's happening here, Brandon? What do you notice?
I noticed that we were looking for ounces and pounds.
Good. He noticed that we have ounces and pounds. Okay? So in order to find that out, we have to do what Jacqueline says. We have to turn it into a proportion. So everybody pick up your reference sheet. Take your finger. Find where you see ounces and pounds. Find where you see ounces and pounds and point to them. Jonathan, what does that say? What are you pointing to on your reference sheet?
1 pound equals 16.
Good. 1 pound equals 16 ounces. That's what our reference sheet tells us. So 1 pound equals 16 ounces. Okay? Now, we know that we started with ounces. So that means we're gonna have to go 2 pounds. So now we're gonna set up our proportion. The easiest way to set this up, you have to make sure that your units are matching, okay? So we got 1 pound equals 16 ounces. Our 112 ounces, where is that gonna go in our proportion? Where is he gonna go? Let's get somebody other than Jack thing. Trinaya, where is 112 ounces gonna go? Is he gonna go under the pounds or under the 16 ounces? Under the 16 ounces, why? Because he's what? Say it loud. Ounces, good. So now we need to find our missing piece here. We need to find our missing piece. We noticed that they're going from 1 pound to 16 ounces. How did they go from 1 to 16? What did they do, Elise?
Times 16.
Times 16. But can we go times 16 at the bottom?
No.
No, because we don't have anything right here. So we have to do what?
Divide.
Divide by what?
16.
Good. Everybody on your paper right now, you're going to divide 112 divided by 16. Good, Ruby. She set it up correctly. Good, Patricia. Good, Brandon. Anybody else have a question? Yes, ma'am, what's your question?
But, can't you do the sides?
Yep. If this doesn't work, you could have went from 16 to 12.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. She also asked a good question. She said, if I couldn't go from horizontal way, can I go to vertical way? Yes, you can.
Oh, you can do that?
You can. You could have went from 16 to 112. What did they multiply by? It's still going to be 7, because 1 times 7 gives me 7. Okay? All right. Everybody go to number 3. I want you to read it for yourself first. I'm going to give you 30 seconds to read it for yourself while I'm erasing the board. You should be able to answer my questions about this problem. Good. Patricia's annotating her problem. Good. We're not just circling things, we're actually understanding. What are we circling? Good. Ruby remembers I gotta bubble my question. All right, 30 seconds up. Who are we dealing with here, Carla? Who are we dealing with here? Morgan, okay. Let's do Patricia. What is Morgan doing here? What is she doing? Okay, she's trying to get her multiplication facts correct. And then what happens as well in our story, Brandon? What happens?
The brother practices multiplication.
What about her brother? What did he do?
He got 16.
Okay, he got 16 correct, and then what happened, Jacqueline?
It increased to
20. It increased to 20. Good. And what is our question looking for, Ruby, since you bubbled it? Good. We're looking for what is the percent increase of the number he got correct. Good. You guys read and annotated your story, so you know what's happening here. Good. If you look on the side, Ms. Thomas gave you a little box that says help. It's been a long time since you guys learned percent increase and decrease. But it's okay though. So number one asks, how much did the increase buy? How much did he increase by? What did he start with, everybody?
16.
And he went to what?
20.
That was an increase of what?
4.
So he went up by 4.
Percent.
Not percent. You got to find a percent. This is how many he increased by. Okay? So we answered number one. He increased by 4. So now you set up your proportion. We have what we changed by. What was the number we changed by, everybody? No, the number we changed by?
4.
Your change over your number you started with. What number did he start with?
16.
Good. 16 equals 2% out of 100. I'm going to give you guys a minute. I want to see you guys do this one on your own. I'm going to come around. I want to see you do this one on your own.
Good movie. Good, Patricia.
Everybody, what's your answer? What did y'all get?
25%.
Good, 25%, because we know that. I saw a lot of you guys do it this way. Everybody noticed that 4 times 4 was 16, but we know we don't have a word, we don't have a number over here. So we have to divide by 4, which gives us 25%. Our answer is D. Okay, good job, everybody. So now you're going to go ahead and continue your independent practice, and then we're going to go ahead and take our exit.